Hello, good morning, guys. Praise God again. We are here to take our breakfast and, of course, to study the Word of God. Interesting po itong ating pag-aaralan today. Well, sa bagay, lahat naman interesting. Ano po ang lahat ng pinag-aaralan natin? The title of our message for today is Elijah Fed by the Ravens. Si Elijah po ay pinakain ng Diyos using the ravens or yung mga uwak. Dito po makikita natin na God really can use anybody or any animal, any bird, anything to bless us if our faith is in God and if we trust totally sa Panginoon. Amen. Let me show you my breakfast. Ano po, bago tayo mag-start. And then we will pray and then we will start. Okay. Ayan, my breakfast is pandesal. Medyo malalaki pandesal dito. Sorry, tingnan nyo po. Ayan na, hindi guys, sa Pilipinas. Ayan, malalaki po yan. Isang pack. And then coffee. Kita nyo po ba? Ayan, coffee, milk, and ngayon, goody peanut butter, and jam. Baguio special jam, strawberry jam, and milk. Okay, USANA vitamin. Mamaya po, nasa kwartong USANA vitamin. And bigla ko na lang po nakita ito sa refrigerator, praise God, na binigay po ng kapatiran. Ano po, maraming salamat po sa nagbigay. I decree and declare 100-fold return be upon you in the name of Jesus. Yan po ay God's principle. When we give, it will be given back to us. Siksik, liglig, at umaapaw ang patuloy na ibibigay ng Lord sa atin. That's how the system of God works. Naka-set up na po yung system na yan. We cannot do anything. Ano po, good or bad, all and everything we give out will return back to us like a boomerang. Amen. But in a multiplied value. Ano po? Well, anyway, before we start, let's have our morning prayer. Amen. Close your eyes, bow your heads, and we will pray. Amen. Heavenly Father, we glorify your name. We bless you. We praise you. We thank you for this beautiful day, Wednesday. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. This is another day of victory, advancement, increase, promotions, success, prosperity, love and joy and peace, wisdom and knowledge and understanding, great blessings and great favor, safety and protection be upon all of us, be upon our families, be upon all the viewers of this video, and be upon their families in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as we study your word, open our spiritual understanding and help us to understand and receive from you and your through your Holy Spirit, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody say, amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay? Mamaya na po ako mag-breakfast. Nauubusan kasi ako ng oras eh. Dito muna tayo sa Word of God. Praise God. Andito po tayo sa 1 Kings chapter 17. Pakita ko po sa inyo yung Bible ko. Ayan. Okay. Ayan, di ba? Andiyan po tayo sa 1 Kings chapter 17. Ito po ay story ni Elijah and how God fed him using the ravens. Ano po, nagkaroon po ng severe famine sa Israel at the time. Why? Because of the people's sin and disobedience against God. Pag tayo po ay lumalayo sa Panginoon, magkakaroon po tayo ng famine, severe famine. Sure po yan. Sapagkat ang Lord ang provider natin, at pag tinalikuran po natin ng Diyos, tatalikuran din po tayo. This is what happened here in Israel. Tumalikod po muli ang bayan ng Israel against God, against our Yahweh, our Jehovah, our God, kaya nagpadala po ng famine ang Panginoon. Okay, nagkaroon po ng tagutong. Okay, so let's read the story. Now Elijah the Tishbite from Tishbe in Gilead said to Ahab, "As the Lord, the God of Israel lives, and whom I serve, there will neither be dew nor rain in the next few years except at my word." Pag wala pong ulan, walang vegetation, walang production, magkakaroon po ng famine talaga. "And God withhold the rain." Pinigil po ng Lord ang rain for 3.5 years. Naku, mabigat po yan. 3.5 years. Yung 1 year nga lang na walang rain eh. Ano po, hindi po tayo makapagtanim sa bukid. Hirap na po tayo. Ang tawag po dyan ay El Nino. Praise God. Hindi po tayo makapagtanim. Therefore, pag walang productivity, walang production, magkakaroon po ng famine. Ito po nangyari sa Israel. Okay, nagkaroon po ng famine. Now, the word of the Lord came to Elijah. In the midst of famine, ibe-bless po ni Lord si Elijah. Hindi pwedeng magutom ang mga lingkod ng Panginoon sapagkat tayo po ay ginagabayan ng Lord. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, "Live here, turn eastward, and hide in the Kerit Ravine, east of Jordan. You will drink from the brook, and I have ordered the ravens to feed you there." The Bible says God ordered the ravens to feed Elijah. Wow! Praise God! Hallelujah! God can use the ravens, the birds, to feed and to bless Elijah para hindi po siya magutom during famine sapagkat wala nga pong pagkain. Ano po? Now, the ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the brook. Habang ang mga tao po ay nagkakagulo dito sa Israel, at kung babasahin po natin itong story completely, they were even cooking their babies and eating their babies. Ganyan po ka-severe ang famine na dumating sa Israel. Magiging kanila mga anak ay niluluto po nila at kinakain po nila. This is the reason why God was angry at these people. Sapagkat they became cannibals na po. Ano? Why? Because they adopted the culture ng mga tao na sa paligid po nila. Kaya importante po, ano, kung sino yung mga tao na sa paligid natin. Why? Because they influence our lifestyle. They influence our thinking. Ano po, na-influence po sila. So they were cooking their babies. They were eating their children. Ano po? But Elijah was fed by the ravens. Nagdadala po ng bread and meat for breakfast. Matutulog si Elijah the whole day, siguro wala na magagawin. And in the evening, magdadala na naman po ng bread and meat. Ang mga birds, ang mga uwak, ano po, at pinapakain po si Elijah. And this is because God commanded the birds. God can command anything. Pwede pong utusan ng Lord ang lahat ng bagay. Remember the story of Jonah? Inutusan po ng Lord ang balyena upang iswallow si Jonah at iluwa muli. Ano po? So God can command any animal, any fish, any bird, anybody. Praise God. At dyan po na natin makikita ang kapangyarihan ng Diyos. So, for a long time, nandun po si Elijah sa tabi ng brook o ng stream. Ano po? Ng batis. At doon po siya nagpapahinga, natutulog, kumakain, nagbabarbecue. Ang sarap po ng buhay ni Elijah. Ano po? Ang sarap po ng buhay niya while the people were cooking their babies sapagkat walang-wala na po silang makain. And many people are dying because of famine. Marami po namamatay. Okay? Praise God. We can relate this into our situation right now. Sa crisis na nangyari po ngayon, COVID. Ano po? Marami pong nawala ng trabaho. Marami negosyong nagsara. Praise God. At marami pong taong nagugutom. But praise God, if we rely on God and declare His promises over our lives, ang Lord ay magpo-provide. God will use and can use anybody to provide anything we need. Lahat ng pagkain ating pangangailangan at lahat po ng salapi na ating kailangan, God can provide. Always declare, "My God shall supply all my needs according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And the Lord is my provider. The Lord is my shield. The Lord is my healer. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want." Praise God. If we declare the promises of God, lahat po ng ito ay mangyayari sa ating buhay. Because God said, "I am watching over my words to fulfill them. And my words will not return to me void, but it shall accomplish the purpose for which I sent them." Kung ano po yung promiso ng Panginoon na nakasulat dito sa Bible, kukunin po natin yan, i-memorize po natin yan, at sasabihin po natin, in the name of Jesus, "My God shall supply all the food that I need, all the monies that I need, according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And then you thank God, Lord, thank you, God, for supplying me all my needs according to Your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Lord, thank You for opening the floodgates of heaven to pour out Your mighty blessings upon me and my family. Lord, thank You. Abundance and prosperity is upon me and my family because You are my shepherd. I shall not be in want. Thank You for blessing my business. Thank You for blessing the works of my hands. Thank You for blessing my family in the name of Jesus. I bless You and I praise You, Lord, in Jesus' name. If you do that every day, the Bible says, when praise goes up, the blessing comes down. Praise God. Hallelujah. When praise goes up, the blessing come down. Kaya patuloy po tayong magpuri sa ating Panginoon at magpasalamat in the midst of crisis. Ang antidote po sa crisis is God. We are thanking God in the midst of crisis. Patuloy po tayong magpuri at magpasalamat sa Panginoon in the midst of crisis at makikita po natin ang pagpapala ng Lord sa ating buhay, kagaya po ng ginawa ng Panginoon sa buhay ni Elijah. Hindi pa po tayo tapos. Listen. Sometime later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, go at once to Zarephath of Sidon and stay there. I have commanded a widow in that place to supply you with food. So he went to Zarephath. Okay? When he came to the town gate, a widow was gathering sticks. He called to her and asked, would you bring me a little water in a jar so I may have a drink? As she was going to get it, he called, and bring me please a piece of bread also. As surely as the Lord your God lives, she replied, I don't have any bread, only a handful of flour in a jar and a little oil in a jug. I am gathering sticks to take them home and make a meal for myself and my son. Then we may eat, then we will die. Sabi po ng widow, wala na. Last na itong flour na ito, last bread na ito, at last oil na rin ito. We will eat this and then we will die. But, praise God, Elijah said to her, don't be afraid. Huwag po tayong matakot. Amen. Praise God. Don't be afraid. Go home and do as I said. But first, make a small cake of bread for me from what you have and bring it to me. And then make something for yourself and your son. For this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. The jar of flour will not be used up, and the jug of oil will not run dry until the day the Lord gives rain on the land. She went away and did as Elijah said. Okay, so there was food every day for Elijah and for the woman and her family. For the jar of flour was not used up, and the jug of oil did not run dry, in keeping with the word of the Lord spoken by Elijah. Praise God. Sumunod po ang widow sa sinabi ni Elijah. Okay, pinagluto po niya ng bread. Ano po, nagprepare po siya ng bread. And then, yung jar, ano po, itong jar ng flour, everyday, pagkukuha po siya, hindi po nauubos yung flour. Samantalang nung dumating po si Elijah sa buhay nitong widow na to, last cooking na po yun, huling luto na yun. Amen? But praise God, by obeying the word of the Lord, the jar did not run dry, and ganun din po, ang jug of oil ay hindi naubusan ng olive oil. Every day, they have bread morning, lunch, and evening until the rain comes after 3.5 years. Purihin po ang Panginoon. God used the ravens to feed Elijah. Now, nung naubos na po ang tubig sa brook of Cherith, God used a widow. A widow to feed Elijah every day. Amen. And Elijah survived. Praise God. Purihin po ang Panginoon. Amen. Patuloy po tayong magtiwala sa Diyos. Patuloy po tayong magpasalamat sa Panginoon. With blessing, no blessing, may ayuda, walang ayuda, say thank you God. Thank you God. Thank you God. Thank you Lord. I praise you. Thank you for supplying us everything we need according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And declare mo, hindi kami magugutom, hindi kami magugutom, hindi kami magugutom, because God is our provider. God is our shepherd. We shall not be in want. He makes us to lie down in green pasture. He leads us beside still waters. He restores our souls. He guides us in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for you are with us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort us. You prepare a table before me, my family, etc., etc. Praise God. Hallelujah. Paubos na po ang aking oras. Hindi ko na po tatapusin ang Psalm 23. But praise God, I hope and I believe that you learned something today from the life of Elijah and from the power of God to provide sa lahat ng kanyang mga minamahal. Amen. Let's love the Lord. Mahalin po natin ang Diyos. Sundin po natin siya. Basahin po natin ang Bible para matutunan po nating mahalin ang Diyos at matuto po tayo sa mga istorya na nakasulat po dito sa Bible kung paano kumikilos ang Diyos sa buhay ng kanyang mga minamahal. Amen. Praise God. Palakpakan po natin ang Lord. If you haven't received Christ as your Lord and Savior, now is the time to receive Him. Lalo na po ngayon, we are in the times of crisis. Ano po? Jesus is our shepherd. He is our provider. Magpo-provide po ang ating Panginoon ng lahat ng ating pangangailangan. Amen? I'm gonna give you a chance to pray this prayer. Follow me in this prayer. Prayer of receiving Jesus as the Lord, as your Lord and Savior. Amen. Close your eyes and bow your heads and follow me in this prayer. Amen. Say, Lord Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I accept you as my provider. I accept you as my healer. I accept you as my peace. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Beginning today, I will love you. I will obey you. And I will follow you for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Congratulations. If you pray that prayer, you have been saved. You are now a child of God. Your name is now written in the Lamb's Book of Life in heaven. When you die, kung patuloy ka naglilingkod sa Lord, you will go to heaven and heaven.